is Nadia Nakai, aka Bragga, and you are tuned into The Element with the Pristine Queen, Azizzar.
It is indeed The Element, rocking real and relevant on Massive Metro. It is 3 minutes before we hit 8 o'clock. And let me tell you something about people who understand timing and time and respect the craft. And you know, have a little bit of respect for your girl, right? I've been saying, Bragga's coming, Bragga's coming. Bragga is here. Okay, she's right next to me. Bragga is here. Make sure that you send through your questions on 074-940-7992. Or you can tweet us. We are at Massive Metro. You can tweet her direct. She's at Nadia_Nakai. I am at Queen Azizzar. And the only hashtag that matters all the way until 9 o'clock is hashtag The Element. We're doing it all for the love of hip-hop. Right, to shut down, whose bar is it anyway? They used to laugh when we were on a tow truck. So me and being broke finally broke up. I think it's very clear by now that it is not a local one. And we took some guesses earlier on. It was a bit creaky. But it was definitely Kanye West on Glow. It is Kanye West and Drake on that one. Big shout out to Don Tavi. I'm not playing your guess. I'm not letting you win again. I need somebody to dethrone you. Guys, please dethrone at Don Tavi. Ki enough, ki khatets. Here is the joint Drake and Kanye West with Glow. On the other side of 8 o'clock, Bragga is talking all things Nadia Naked. I'm hella excited. If you're not, I got hella khain. I mean, wow. Sis, what a mess.
Yo. Money, babe, money, bay. Them Rendellas bag. Money, babe, money, babe, money, bay. Let's get it.
You understand if you have been out to the live shows, that's the part where the gunshots come in. Right at the end of that performance. And we're like, oh my God. Some Millie Rock action.
Yeah,
it is 8 minutes after 8 o'clock. Here we are actually at the shows. You know,
you we're not just out here.
I have to tell you, Bragga, I've seen you so many times on stage.
Really?
All the time.
I'm so glad.
And it never gets tired. I'm like, okay. So I know the vibe. It is 8 minutes after 8 o'clock. And I did say that Bragga is here. And it is the Stripes Hour. We're talking all things Nadia Naked. So I'm going to be playing the Now Me in Bed all hour, and make sure that you send through your questions through to her on 074-940-7992 so that you can ask her your questions yourself. And if you just have comments, what you think about the album, which joint is your favorite joint, which one should be the next one, which one should have a BDO, which ones should have videos. I already know my picks, but it's not about me. It is about you. 074-940-7992 at Massive Metro. Hashtag The Element, or you can tweet Nadia direct at Nadia_Nakai. And if you care about me, I'm at Queen Azizzar. Mm. Bragga.
Hi, Queen.
What's good, babes?
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm okay. I'm fantastic.
First of all, thank you for coming out, even though you've got a cold.
You're welcome. For you, I always come.
We have to say, people's time is important, guys, and I don't take it for granted. So
thank
I really,
you.
Really appreciate it. Bright pink hair.
Yes, I did this just for you. I really did this.
Who told
just
you
for
pink
you?
Is my favorite color?
Is it really? I'm
it
so.
It really,
like, you
really
know,
is.
Our minds are just.
We are connected. In the sink.
We definitely
right.
in the sink.
Tell me, how does the breeze on your bottom feel now that you are so naked out there for everybody to see? Yeah.
It's amazing because the thing is that, like, I keep talking about how it's been 2.5 years. And
yeah.
I feel like people don't know about me and what I'm about or what I was trying to do with the things that I did and how I felt about certain things. And I knew that because it took so long and I've been able to grow with my fans the way I have, it was only right for me to bear myself in all my, like, nudity when it comes to music, you know, to just allow people to into my world and understand me. And I think that's why they love it so much, because I think at the beginning of your career, it's very hard to come out automatically talking about your truth because you haven't grown with your fans. Whereas with me, I have fans. I remember when I was on battle stations. I remember fans when they know me when I was on Planet Radio or I was releasing my first music video, like me.
Yeah,
I have fans like that. So I think they appreciated that part of me in the album.
I thought that it was very, very brave. There are so many different layers, so many different nuances. A lot of people were like, how naked is she actually going to get?
Yeah.
And I remember at the launch you were saying, I think there was about 50 joints that could have been a possibility for the album, and obviously you had to cut.
Yeah.
How do you even go about deciding what stays and what goes?
That is so difficult. It involves a lot of people.
Yeah.
You know, you make music and you kind of count down to, like, probably like 25 songs.
Yeah.
Then you start, like, playing it for, like, other people, see what they think, and be like, okay, cool. But you need to also keep very cognizant of what message you're trying to portray, and does it still have a golden thread and all that. So that was like a difficult one to cut down to. I actually was supposed to cut down to 14.
What?
So 17 was like, I'm like, I can't cut down anything else. Like everything on that album needs to be there now. I can't take it down to 14.
Okay, tell me about maybe one or two of the joints that didn't make it onto the album. And you're like, ah!
There's a song called Rider. Oh my gosh, there's a song that we did with Ty Wonder called Rider.
Yeah.
And it's got like an Afro pop feel, and I'm on the joint by myself, and I freaking love that joint. I love that joint so much, but it didn't make the album. There's another one that I did with Frank Casino, actually, yeah. And that also didn't make the album, but I was so in love with that joint. His verse was so amazing on that joint. There's another one called it's got the horns like Big Pun. I forgot what it's called.
Yeah.
What's the name? Cardi B dropped one similar to that, Drip.
Oh,
then
okay.
I was like, okay, I can't drop Drip because Drip, Cardi B dropped Drip. So yeah, so that one didn't make the album either, but it's a really dope joint.
Okay, so you cut down to 17, but they wanted you to cut down to 14. Which three joints did you fight for? Like, yo,
I didn't know. I was just telling him it's 17. It wasn't like fighting for 17. You know, the problem for me was because I haven't dropped an album for 2.5 years,
right.
You know. So my problem was, if I went down to 14, my album was going to include Yes Chick. Yes Bitch. Can I
mean, you already done
it. Sorry. And and now Mean. So those songs are really out, which means I was only going to drop 12 songs. Hell no. Not off an album that everybody's been waiting for.
For such a long time
to just give them only 12 songs.
Yeah.
So I was like, no. Because of Yes Chick and Na Mean, I definitely had to have a substantial number of new joints.
Yeah.
You know? Me man, I'm too real. You chicks go to the mall and shop a new heel. I tell my manager, nah, go shop a new heel. We actually had a million views. A lot of people different brands. Think about what they say and how they say it, because of the image and the brand or whatever. And it's like, brands should buy into your brand. You shouldn't put your brand into your brand.
Exclusive to The Element. Turn down the lights. On Massive Metro.
That's what it is. It is Stripes with Nadia Nakai all the way until 9 o'clock. Just played you Boss. I'm a boss.
I'm a boss.
Yeah, but I can't be saying the B word. I'm a boss.
I'm a boss.
Off of Nadia Naked. What joint do you play the most right now from your album?
You know, I've been listening to my album for a very long time.
Are you over it?
No, I'm not. I'm listening okay. to every song. Like, I'm listening to it like with new, fresh ears. Like,
yeah.
Because I know it so well. I literally listen from beginning to end because I'm trying to listen to it as a first time listener now.
Yeah.
You know, and how they're going through the process. Because one song that surprised me a lot is that people really liked Amai.
Yeah.
I didn't expect them to like that song. And that was actually one of the last songs that I recorded for the project. And I was like, I'm so happy that they loved it, because I thought there I was just letting loose, and I was just like, you know, just telling people about my life and my family. And I played it for my mom probably like the week of my launch. So that one was surprising for me, for them to actually really enjoy that one.
That's the one that is about your mom. Hey, you said yes. it means mom in
Shona.
In Shona.
Yes.
I thought it was so cute. We're like, Mom, how's my Shona? She's like, Yeah, it's fine.
And the thing is that I didn't even consult her to be like, how do you say this word? Because that's how real I wanted my album to be. That if I mispronounce things and people in Zimbabwe, they'll be like, she promised me. And I want to be like, yes, because I'm born here, I'm bred here.
Yeah.
My Shona isn't terrible, but it's the way that I am. I'm not gonna lie and pretend like my Shona is fantastic on a song, and then when you meet me, it's broken.
Yeah,
it is what facts. It is. You know.
Tell me about it. I think especially because I think what was very surprising for me, I think especially at the launch when you were speaking about it, was speaking about your dad.
Yeah.
Because I personally didn't know about you, and what impact did his not really being there have on you as a woman?
I don't know. Like, for me, I've never felt broken. I've never felt like I missed anything in my life. I never remember myself sitting in my room saying, oh man, I wish my dad was there. You know, I think that my mom raised me, and she was so focused on me that I didn't feel like I was missing anything. The only thing that I would say is that I didn't feel like I could really talk to my mom about him, you know, and not talk about him because he's something that I miss in my life, but just to understand like what happened, you know, that was always difficult for me. That's what I was talking about in the song, because I think you don't want to bring up your dad as a kid sometimes because you think you're going to offend your mom, you know, and make her feel like she's not doing enough, not doing great. And if your dad was here, it would be fantastic.
It would be better.
And it's never the case, you know. So I was always scared to ask that question and find out more about that because I didn't want to offend her.
Yeah.
And that was kind of my life, but I never felt like, I know what a good man looks like. I don't think I needed my father figure in my life to know what a good man looks like and how he should treat a woman and what should happen and how things should happen in a family dynamic.
Yeah.
You know, and I honestly don't feel like I'm broken in any way. My mom really raised me to be very strong, And I'm grateful for the way that she did things.
Yeah. And now that Amai is a real thing and it's out and everything, what is it like for your mom, with your mom, you and your mom now?
So I called her after the listening session because she had heard listened to the album and she was just like, it's so amazing, it's so fantastic. And she didn't feel offended at all as well. It's because I feel like we still have to have that conversation about dad. I think so. Like, because it's always been like drips and drives, but I think we still need to have a conversation like properly and really to understand exactly what was going on during that time, you know? And she's so proud. And the only thing that I was concerned about wasn't even that song. I was more concerned about the swear words and that.
I remember.
Because I know she's going to feel uncomfortable. My granny was there also, but they were all like amazed. And the thing is that at that venue, the lift gave up at some point.
Did it?
I think so.
No, we were freaked out at some point because they were like, if more than 8 people get on this,
it's going to get stuck. Stop.
I was like, so there was a time when there was like 10 people in front of us. You guys go ahead.
Yeah, rather.
I'm not really trying to do all of that.
For real. There's a time when that happened and my gran actually has a back problem and she went up those stairs and my mom was literally pushing my gran up the stairs because she refused to not go. She was like, I'm not going home. I know there's no lift. It's like, no, but you have a back problem. My mom was literally pushing my grandmother up the stairs. She got there, she was so worried. Like, I don't know, maybe we need to take her to the doctor tomorrow, but she was fine. But that was just like how much it was so important to my family to be there, you know?
That's really, really beautiful. And I remember, like, you have your family out as much as you possibly can. Even when you launched
the sports scene,
the sports scene range, that was really, really dope for us to see. Why is it so important for you to bring them into that part of your life as well?
Because I think that's the only part that I can really bring them into, you know. I can't take them to the clubs, I can't take them to the festivals, you know. I can't, you know. And it's so hard to let them see things that I'm doing and be proud of it because they can't get in. My little brother's 9. My mom is like not trying to be in the club and the festivals and you know. So she's not trying to be in that life. So when I do like magazine covers or I do like launches and stuff like this album launch, I definitely want them to be there because that's the only place I can make sure they're comfortable, they're looked after, and it's not too rowdy.
And they
can
still experience
what I do.
Alrighty, it is 22 minutes after 8 o'clock. I'm going to play you a song that people think is going to be the next one.
Which one is it? Because it's between Creatures and More Drugs.
More Drugs.
More Drugs.
Okay. Yeah. That makes me emotional. It makes me feel like I went through a breakup. Kalikili single marois, but it makes me feel like,
yeah, but I feel like everybody in their life has gone through some sort of breakup. Even if it's not like a relationship.
No, that's true.
There's something.
That's true. I'm just not trying to remember my last breakup.
Okay, I'm sorry.
More Drugs. Nadia Nakai. Let's hear. It's a dope song though.
Thank you. Slow down. My Titanic, yeah, the hell is going down. I'm on a lifeboat, watch the loose to drown. Yeah, I'm too far, I never hit the ground. Wait, slow down. My Titanic, yeah, the hell is going down. I'm on a lifeboat, watch the loose to drown. Yeah, I'm too far, I never hit the ground. Gotta keep it 100 when I see him in public. Instagram, got you faking angles, just to see your stomach. Never been on a budget, had to come out the dungeon. Niggas be talking crazy, I'm addressing the subject. Made it on magazines. A million streams. Yeah, I did it, not me.
Did you get it, not me?
I stayed on their mind, even out of sight. Not me, Bragga. They seem to whip out Bragga. Your kicks to click on Kaga. On Chaga. Not me, Bragga. They seem to whip out Bragga. Your kicks to click on Kaga. On Chaga.
On Chaga. It is Nadia Nakai and Kuli Chana with On Their Block.
Oh, Kuli, you know,
Bragga. Woo, that's the vibe.
Kuli had to be the first verse actually that I got for the album.
What?
Well, other than Frank, which is a song that didn't make it, but
oh yes.
I'm just saying, like, he was the first verse I got, period. Even before Casper, even before Techo, even before Ebrady.
How did that feel?
That was surreal for me because, like, everyone that I've worked on, I've, like, been around and I've got, like, a relationship with, and, you know, like, and Kuli, like, we don't really hang out like that, you know? So that one was very far-fetched for me, and I was like, I don't know if he's gonna do it. I don't know if he's a fan of me.
What
if he doesn't like me? I don't know, but this is something that I really wanted to do. When I heard this song, I was like, there's nobody else that can jump on the song for me other than Kuli. You know, and luckily I was just able to find his number somewhere, and I just hollered him. I said, listen, I have this song, can I send it to you? And I'm so grateful that he loved it and jumped on it. So
how does it feel when you know the people that you look up to like that have respect for you in general, but enough respect to be a part of your baby?
It's so motivating, because I think during the journey of everything, you can get so demotivated along yeah. the way, because you think that people don't see what you're doing. People don't see the strides that you're doing for the industry or yourself, or
yeah.
the accomplishments that you get. And then you feel like, okay, am I really doing anything? Am I really impacting anything? But then when something like this happens, and you actually think that, okay, no, but that means he has been seeing me.
Yeah.
Which means other people have been seeing me, you know, and seeing what I'm trying to do and who I am and how I'm trying to impact the culture as a whole, you know. So that was so motivating for me. Like, having him on there was just like insane.
Were you scared? You know, I would imagine, like, having somebody like that on my job, I'd be like, I can't.
I wasn't.
Oh my God. It's coolie.
I wasn't scared, because On the Block technically has 3 verses of mine on it yes. already, you know. So I was like, he has to be on the song. Like, he has to be on the song. There's no way. But if he wasn't going to be on the song, I wasn't going to get anyone else. Like, if it wasn't him, then it was just going to be me. I wasn't going to replace him with anyone else yeah. because he felt so, like, organic on that joint for me. So I wasn't scared that he would say no. I was just like, if he says no, it's okay. I'm just going to keep the song on anyway.
Yeah.
But the fear was actually asking him, period. Just getting the courage to be like, hi, coolie, it's Nadia Nakai. Oh, no.
Bragga still gets nervous.
All the time. You yeah. don't understand. Like, all the time. I still meet people like I just don't get it. When Nasty posted that he listened to the song, in my head I'm just like, Nasty's listening to my album. Nasty's listening to my album. What do you mean? What? What now must happen? Okay, what?
Oh my God.
I wish I could, like, just repost everybody and put them like, this person listened to my album and they tweeted it.
Yeah.
This person listened to my album and they tweeted it. I'm the bomb.
So in as much as you don't make moves for validation, right?
Yeah.
Because you're a very confident person and you're very secure in who you are and where you are. So I don't believe that you make any moves like, I really hope people are gonna love me or whatever.
Yeah.
But how does it feel when you are getting as much respect as you are getting? Especially now, there was a point in time in your career when it seemed like people really didn't believe.
Yeah.
You know, and people were like, okay, who is this chick? Why is she here?
Yeah.
When is she leaving? Right.
I think.
And now it's very, very
apparent.
Different.
But because I have a good album, you know, I think everyone in the industry, well, people that I've encountered with believed, you know, because I've known them for long. I mean, Questa, this is not the first song we've done. We've done about 3 songs that just never came out.
Yeah.
Tito, we've done like 3 songs and there's one that finally made his album.
Yes.
But like, we've constantly been working and they never would have taken the time to work with me if they didn't believe some sort, you
yeah.
know, of what was trying to be made or happen.
Yeah.
I think there's always a lot of doubt, but there's also always a lot of love. You know, people forget that there's people that love you and there's people that hate you.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously when people are hating on you, that gets a lot more attention. But I would never say there was doubt, because there were people that really believed in me, like always believed in me and always said, this is what's going to happen, we're going to be there, we're going to wait in line. I sold out in 2 weeks with Bragga merchandise. If people didn't believe before
very
my album
annoying.
Sorry,
very annoying, because wow. You know when you go to sports and I'm looking for the Bragga, which is
sorry, he's been moved to
maybe go to like Mall of Africa. Ha, Mall of Africa. Because Mall of Africa is far, guys.
Yeah,
for me. Anyway.
For a lot of people.
Sorry, do you have the Bragga? No.
Okay. Sorry. I don't know
it's
what to
hard
tell
life.
You.
But new merch is coming.
Yes, it's dropping on this Saturday, 13th July.
And
I'm about to drop the new stuff. It's so exciting. It's for the winter range.
Yeah,
I'm excited to drop it. People are gonna okay, so no, what I'm trying to say is, like, you know, that Castle Light outfit that everyone's going whoa. Okay, I'm a rap position, but that's what I do. Okay, I show my bumps, relax, you know, that's what I can do. But like, that outfit is actually part of my Bragga range that's dropping now on the 13th. You guys are talking about it. You're gonna make me sell out. You guys are really do it. I want Chakura.
But you know what it is? Let me tell you what it is, Nadia. I believe that a part of the change in the way that people perceive you is because you inspire people to be unapologetically
about
who they
exactly.
are.
Exactly.
And I think that when you came out and you're like, this is me, I got a nice butt, I'm gonna put it out today. Oh,
and
today I don't feel like it. I wanna dress
cover up
and
yeah.
be sophisticated and look like a 60s movie star.
Yeah.
But everything that you do is genuinely you, just
yeah.
different parts of you. And when that happens, people get inspired to live their truth and walk in their truth as well.
Thank you.
You know, and people are very afraid, especially women, to
yeah.
show that sexy, flexy side, that ratchet ass side as well. And
yeah.
I think that in you owning those different parts of you, you've told other women it's okay.
It is. And it's like, I appreciate that you've noticed that, because I haven't had this conversation with you before.
Yeah.
And that's why, like, even when I go to interviews and they say, what would you like us to talk about? I'm like, talk about the album, talk about my single, talk about my merchandise, and talk about that Castle Light outfit. Because I want you to talk about it, because of the fact that I realize that women put themselves in boxes, and they constantly put themselves in boxes, and I don't understand why. Then I realize the conversations that women have with their fathers or with their husbands or their boyfriends. You know, they taught to dim their light. Mm-hmm. You know, in African culture, it's always women need to be a little bit lesser. You need, like, that speech Beyonce and did.
Submit to your man
and whatever.
It's
all about the man and how you represent the man and how you add to the man. And it's like, no, I don't think we should do that. So therefore, it's been entrenched in our DNA that we constantly, now women bring down other women that are liberating and actually coming out of themselves, because it's not normal.
Yeah.
That's what I don't want. I want to change that. I'm not saying I'm going to be able to change the whole societal, like, traditional situation, but for me, that's what I'm trying to do. I want people to be confident, women to be confident in themselves and not put themselves in boxes.
Yeah.
If you want to go out and celebrate your femininity and your sexuality, do that. Don't ever feel like you can't do what you want because people say you have to be this certain type of an individual.
Yeah.
So for me, I'm all about it. Ask questions and I'll tell you. I'm definitely going to wear bums. I'm going to wear a tracksuit, or I'm going to wear a gown. I'm like, guys, like, seriously.
Okay, you got a really nice ass. What
thank
you do?
Thank you.
What you do to get it?
Nothing, because I actually don't work out and I don't go to the gym.
You're rude. What?
I'm actually starting to train now because I'm preparing for my tour, so I need to actually now start dancing and actually getting a little bit more fit.
No. I need a break. You don't work out. You don't squat.
No, I actually need to squat because I have like a bum that comes like out, but I don't have like hips. You know, like my hips are not like shaped like that. So now I need to squat so my hips do like that oval circle, so I can do that, because my bum is like just protrudes
Nadia
out.
Nadia doesn't squat. I was having a chat with my best friend Motsi today, and I was like, "Friend, my butt is gone since I've been in the gym." And she's like, "You gotta squat. You gotta squat.
You gotta
friend,
squat."
Friend, Nadia doesn't squat. What you gotta say now? Yeah.
Dominators of the game, exclusive to the Element. Turn down the lights. Massive Metro
indeed. Another 17 minutes before we have to get out of here and make room for the grown and sexy, for Eddie Mukhali, your brother for the night. That is for those of you who are in the loves, you know, who are cuddled up at night, all those nice things. And an electric blanket.
Okay. Electric blankets are amazing.
I mean, yes, Ren, but they don't, you know, have chests that you can put your head on.
Yeah, I guess so.
You understand?
Yeah, it's not the same.
Yeah, it's rather tricky, but we'll be fine. I will be singing a different tune in a few months. I claim it.
In the name of Jesus.
No, seriously, Jesus got to come back. Something about this. 15 minutes before we hit 9 o'clock, what did I play you before this? I played some Raga Raga. I'm a boss, call me Bragga. That's where the name came from, right?
That is what
you mean. Yeah. You see, we're paying attention. We're out here.
I feel like you pay attention.
I have to.
Yeah, it's good.
I have to. I like things also. You know, I'm a journalist by profession, so looking for the things.
I get it now. Are you really?
I really am.
Okay, then it makes complete
sense.
I did
my honors in journalism at UJ.
Is it?
Yes.
You and Uhelen are like my favorite people to interview.
Yay!
Because you guys actually come with like proper questions and actually know what the hell you're talking about.
I have to tell you, I look up to Helen. Like, every time Helen is around, I'm like,
yeah, she's amazing. Hi, but you're also fantastic.
Thank you. Downplaying yourself. I appreciate that. The boy robot boy says that the chat is lit. So shout out to him, and also to Mutsidisimu Hono, saying that this is a dope interview. I've also got some messages for you, Bragga. People have some things to say. Yeah. Okay, so let me kill your bed, Ganani. There we go. And there is the first one.
Nadia, you kept us waiting for a very, very long time, but tell you what, it's so, so worth it. You are so important to the game. Keep pushing, keep hustling, keep being a boss, keep showing us how it's done, keep being amazing, you know, and just living your truth, being authentic, being awesome, being professional. Thank you so much for that. And keep taking it to the top, Bragga. We're watching, we're supporting. We love you.
Oh, thank you. I love how she started. She was like, Nadia.
Ewen.
Ewen. Like, I got that a lot. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. What's her name? Do you know her
name? That is Mutsi DC Mohono. Nice. You know Mutsi?
Nice to see you.
She interviewed you when you were here on Breakfast. Oh, wow.
Really?
Ago.
Breakfast is scary.
Yeah, no. But you came with your A game that day. I was like, oh my God. Because I think I had heard that you don't really like the mornings, but you will show up.
Yeah, the mornings are bad. I'm not a morning person. I wake up at like 12, 1 o'clock every day.
You said this before and I was very upset with
you.
Because at that time I was waking up at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Okay, that will never be me.
And I think that's why she's speaking about your professionalism.
Thank you.
I appreciate that about you as well. You always show up.
Yeah.
And if you cannot make it, you communicate.
Yeah.
But I don't think I've ever had a situation where it's like, oh,
no, they're like,
what
I don't
must
know
to can happen.
Definitely not you, but no. It has obviously happened before. But I do communicate, and I'll say, sorry, I won't be able to make it. Because
life happens sometimes.
It does, yeah. Sometimes you have like car issues, or like these days I've been having serious car issues. Like I locked my keys somewhere. I left them in Durban. Now it's just like, wow.
Sorry, I'm at the part where you left your keys in Durban.
I definitely left my keys in
Durban. What was happening? How
was
good was the
groove
celebration?
Oh. It was really dope. But it was just like, yeah, no, it is what it is. They're gone.
All right, speak to me about your relationship with your best friend Pindi, just because of the fact that a lot of people get people that they love and care about to be in their business,
yeah,
because of the fact that they feel safe and there's loyalty there. But sometimes it doesn't always work, because sometimes the person who might love you the most might not necessarily have the skill.
Yeah,
but that has not been the case. How did you guys help that happen?
So to be honest with you, like, her and I are best friends. We work together at an advertising agency. That's where we met, and we've been best friends for the longest time. But the honest part of it is that she's not, we're not working together because she's my best friend. Like, we work together because she's damn good at her job. Like, she's really good. She's a hustler. She is outgoing. And no matter if she was managing me or not, I feel like she would always be successful because of the type of personality she is. She doesn't take no for an answer. She's not scared. Like, she goes out and gets whatever she wants, you know?
At all.
As herself, you know? So that was just amazing to be able to work with her on my brand and what I'm trying to do at the moment, because you need people like that around you. Because I'm not as outgoing as her. You might think I am, but I'm not a person that's going to just walk up to a person and be like, I want this, this, and this, and this. I'm very more like, I don't know if I should ask or whatever.
Is it okay if? Would you mind?
Like,
I mean, you don't have to, but.
Exactly. I'm that person.
Would you?
Yeah, which is not going to get you very far. So she's really good at what she does, and she takes the bull by the horns. And she tells her what to do.
I can attest to that. I remember I met Pindi over the phone when I was still working at the paper. And I was just like, I like this girl.
Yeah.
And she'd always be like, yo.
Yeah.
And she always came through. But I think what I really appreciate about the way that you guys work is that she really will go to war for you.
Yeah.
She really, really, really will.
Yeah, she will. No, she does. I mean, like, there's things that happen and she'd be like, and that's what you want your friends to do, is like, whoever we mad at, we are all mad at. Like, all of us, we're not messing with this person. That's what girls do. I
that's
mean,
dope.
You know,
I really like that. Let's take one more message.
Okay.
Is it happening?
Hi, Nadia. This is Ntabeleng. I am one of your biggest fans that you actually have. I was heartbroken when you couldn't make it last week, because I was actually at the station last week.
I'm sorry.
And I'm very, very, very heartbroken that I'm not there today when you're actually physically there. I just wanted to say thank you for what you've been doing for us. I really, really do love your music. And I love the type of person that you are. And I wish you all the best going forth with your music. And yeah, you should show them who's boss out there in the streets, yeah? Your album is amazing. Love, 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 love the album. Queen, can you please tell her to come back when I'm actually there so I can actually have a picture with her and get to meet her? Like, I'm actually so heartbroken that she's there and I'm not. Wow.
I'm sorry. Oh, this is really wow. That one with it. Wow.
Shout out to Ntabeleng. First of all, show me when I let drama.
Wow.
Wow, darling.
Nadia, will you come back when she's here?
Yeah, well, I definitely
you know what? Actually, what I will commit to is I will bring her out to a show.
Please do. That'd Let's be really do that. Cool.
I'll bring her out to a show, yeah, and then we can take pictures there rather than in the studio.
Yeah, I think that'll be cool.
I think that'll be dope as well. It's your heart. 8 minutes before.
Nine o'clock.
Go. Look, we gotta go just now. Oh, no, wait. This clock says there's 9 minutes. I'll take the one that gives us more time.
Yeah.
But for now, here is Bragga with Namin. Yeah, I know the words. Don't mess with me. I know the words to this one. Watch the live.
And your scripts, I sign a cash for. Be the master, running up on him like Casper. Get your cash up, or you push it look like last year. Need a catch up, you then I'm still a bastard. Actually Rashford, free kicks for you, think I'm bastard.
Money never
That's
been
my
an
problem.
Issue.
That's what I got.
Magazine covers need an issue. Not them need a tissue. It's painful issue. Not me. Be your magazine. Make a flip beam.
Pull up in a four-door Audi. Dropped a milli on my bus and my Audi. All the champagne got me feeling rowdy. Windows down cause the shit is kinda cloudy. Nah, I mean, you know I'm rowdy.